It has shared administrative space with the tropical disease research center on the 60th floor of the Ndola Central Hospital, teaching labs which are shared with the biomedical college and the specific teaching areas provided by the Ndola Central Hospital. In fact, without the Ndola Central Hospital and without the assistance of our colleagues in the Ministry of Health, this whole dream of the School of Medicine would not have happened. So these shared areas have posed the challenge to a rapidly growing medical teaching facility, now largely met by this modern infrastructure on a 54 hectare plot. The school currently has the following programs: medicine and surgery, dental surgery, clinical medicine. There were 73 numbers of students who began the program in medicine and in surgery, 21 in dental surgery, and 52 in medicine, which is ME surgery. Of these, 33 from the medicine and surgery, and 19 from the dental surgery successfully completed their programs. Massive gratitude must surely go to those many institutions and people from the ministries of higher education, ministries of health, ministries of finance, World Health Organization, WHO, and other UN institutions, including the Zambian General Community and its late chairperson, Mr. Michael Galun. Without their timely actions and resolve, what we have today at the Copperbelt University will not have happened.
Ladies and gentlemen, I join the Vice Chancellor in welcoming you to this special occasion. It is special on two accounts. First, this year's graduation ceremony marks the 25th time the Copperbelt University has been conferring degrees. Clearly, the university has come of age. Second, the university graduating its first cohort of medical doctors. Further, it is a momentous occasion in that the Copperbelt University is showcasing a brand new school of medicine with state-of-the-art infrastructure and there's need to come up with measures which can be implemented to heal the nation and re-establish and strengthen national unity and peace. In conclusion, allow me to send special congratulations to the first cohort of medical doctors to graduate from the medical Michael Chilufya Sata School of Medicine. To further congratulate the others who have been conferred with postgraduate diplomas and postgraduate degrees. And finally, to commend the staff and management of the Commonwealth University for this milestone, the 25th graduation ceremony, which marks a quarter of a century of adding the school, human resource school of the country and beyond. Honourable Minister, distinguished guests, very gentlemen, I thank you all for your patience.
We are now going to institutionalize research. The way we get hired to be lecturer at grade 3, we also have researcher grade 3. And rise to senior lecturer, as well as rise to senior researcher. That is an important aspect of the university that is going to improve the financing of the university. When I was a student at the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine, we competed for grants. And part of that grant came in for the administration of the department. We should have UNICEF paying for the deans of pediatrics for the work that they take on behalf of UNICEF. And also the UNFPA paying for the chair of OPS and IE. So this is the way we're going to move. We are going to work hard, we're going to form partnerships, we are going to make linkages, and I love the fact that the Copperbelt University has already started making the the linkages that are important, such as your friends from Korea, and I believe the friends from Israel, and that's the way it should be, and we should search more. This country is receiving lots of universities here. We have, for example, Boston University operating in Zambia. Should they be in Kamulonga or in whatever, in Riverside, renting a property? Or should they be part of the medical school here and working here and also sharing the knowledge that they are acquiring here with the rest of the team here? These will be things that together, Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, Chair of the University Council, we shall be exploring, and very quickly in the next few weeks, to reposition our institutions to be the leaders and the ones that actually become the kingpin of the economic development of this country.